This screencast, I want to do a derivation of the heat diffusion equation in cylindrical coordinates. And the reason you might come across this equation, or the reason you might find it useful, is that you could be faced with a problem where you need to calculate or derive the temperature profile for a cylindrical geometry. So as an example, you might have a copper wire with an electrical current flowing through it, and then there's some convective heat transfer on the exterior, and the temperature of the interior of this is greater than the temperature of the exterior of it. Another example you might come across would be the temperature distribution across the walls of a pipe. So you might have hot water flowing through the center of the pipe, and the exterior of the pipe is cooler than the interior. And in both cases, you can use this equation to derive those temperature profiles. Well, it may not look like it. All this equation is an energy balance around a differential element. And what it says is that the rate at which thermal energy is being stored within a small volume is equal to the rate at which energy is entering minus the rate at which thermal energy is leaving, plus any rate of thermal energy generation. So thermal energy could be generated, for example, as an electric current or maybe a chemical or a nuclear reaction, for example. Three axes that we need in cylindrical geometry. The first would be the axial dimension, which we call z in this case. So z is the length along this rod. The second is the radial direction, or the distance from the center of the rod. And the third is this angular direction, which we call phi, which gives us the angular position from some starting point. So on the right, what I've drawn is a geometric depiction of a differential control volume. Vertically, in this case, I've got my z-axis. In the radial direction, I've got this variable r. And in the angular direction, we use a variable phi. So you can see the three of those. We see the variable r, phi, and z in this differential equation, which we'll derive. What I've drawn is a differential control element, or differential control volume. It's characterized by the dimensions, say dz in the vertical dimension, and dr in the radial direction, and a distance r d phi in this angular direction. Now that we've got r times some change in angle, this r is in front for dimensional consistency. Let's examine the net flow of energy into this control volume. We'll think about the three different dimensions, and in the vertical direction, we can call it qz entering the control volume from the bottom. Energy flowing in from the back in the radial direction we'll call q dot r, and there's energy flowing in the angular direction, or the direction of increasing phi, into this face on the left, and we'll call that q dot phi. So that was energy coming in from the three faces. Now what I'm showing is energy leaving. I've got energy leaving in the radial direction on this front face, so leaving in the direction of increasing r, leaving in the axial direction, or the direction of increasing z, this top face right here, and then on the this back face, leaving in the angular direction, which I call q dot phi plus d phi. So those are the ways energies can be conducted into or out of the control volume. In the third term we need to consider is the rate of thermal energy generation. The rate of thermal energy generation is this term q dot multiplied by the volume of this control element. So we've got q dot times a volume, or we could say q dot times, let's say we want dr times dz, the vertical dimension, multiplied by r d phi. And this is analogous to a rectangular geometry where we say the length times the width times the height. So in this case, r d phi is the width. We've got the height of it dz and the length of it dr. And finally, the rate at which thermal energy is being stored is proportional to the heat capacity and the rate the temperature is changing. So we take the mass, or the density times this volume, dr times r d phi dz. Density times the volume is a mass multiplied by the heat capacity times the rate at which the temperature is changing. So here I've written it all out. I've got the energy stored term, the energy coming in, the energy coming out through the other three faces, and then the energy being generated. One thing we need to figure out is how does the heat leaving at Q R plus dr compare to the heat entering at QR? So how does the heat leaving from this face, this front face, compare to the amount of heat coming in from this back face? We can do it for all three dimensions, the R, the phi, and the Z dimension, by way of Taylor series expansions, which I've done down in here. So with these expansions, we can plug in values now for Q R plus dr in the phi and the Z components of it. When I make the substitution, what we'll find is that these QRs will drop out because of the negative sign, and the QPs just as well, and QZs will also drop out because of the negative signs in the expression. So here's what we're left with after making the substitution. On the left is the energy storage term. On the right, the last term is the energy generation term. And these three terms now in the middle represent the net rate at which energy is entering the control volume. What we need to do now is show how the flow of energy in the R, phi, and in the Z directions, QR, Qphi, and QZ, how can we relate those to the temperature? And we can do that by looking at Fourier's law. Let's examine the flow of energy in the radial direction first. What I've written is QR is equal to negative K dt dr times R d phi dz. And what I'm writing is simply the total flow of energy, or the net flow of energy in the R direction, is equal to the flux, which is negative K dt dr. The flux times this cross-sectional area, or I should say the area of this face, which is R d phi, this length times dz, or this height, or the area in the back and the area in the front of this. And I could do something analogous for the angular direction, this phi direction, and in the z direction. So in the phi direction, I'm talking about the area dr dz, so this area here and this area in the back of it. And in the z, or the axial direction, I'm talking about the area on the bottom and the top of our control volume. Note the presence of the r in the denominator's phi direction. And the presence of that r is to make the equation dimensionally homogeneous. So we're talking about a differential change in the distance in this angular direction. So we've got r d phi. So let's make the substitution. We'll put in for qr, q phi, and qz. So here's what we're left with after making the substitution. We've got the energy stored term, the three net energy transport into and out of the control volume now with, in terms of temperature, and then finally the energy generation term. And finally, the last thing to do is to divide by this dr times rd phi dz, divide both sides of the equation. Well, it'll fall out in the energy generation term, it'll fall out in the energy storage term, and we'll see some combination of it in the net energy coming in minus energy leaving. And so here you have it, the heat diffusion equation in cylindrical coordinates.